Hey folks, welcome back to the episode with Cooking with Gadgets. Today we're gonna make up some homemade meatballs. That's right, we're gonna make the sauce up fresh, meatballs up fresh. Meatballs are gonna be steamed in the Veroma dish. Yes, that's right, we're using the gadget of choice, the Thermomix. We have the recipe all keyed up here. Our ingredients are all fresh. We have garlic, we have some basil, some parsley. I'm gonna put a little bit of rosemary in there just to give it a little kick of smell. We got two eggs. We got our breadcrumbs soaking in milk, fresh onions, ground beef, about 16 ounces, that's a pound, fresh olive oil from Provisions here in Waxhaw, North Carolina. And of course, we got our crushed tomatoes for tomato sauce. Stay with me, this is gonna be fun. I'm gonna like the smell of this because I've been hunkering for some meatballs, guys. That's right, I said hunkering. It's one of those old southern terms. Alrighty, we put our first set of ingredients in there. We put our garlic, parsley, and some basil in there. I add a little bit of rosemary. That's my special kick to it. I want to smell it. And now this recipe said garlic was optional. I'm just going to have to act like a Christian and say, Satan, get thee behind me on that one, because who in the world would not want to put some garlic in a spaghetti recipe, spaghetti sauce, meatballs? Get out of here. So I put that garlic in there. Gonna move on to the next step. Stay with me. Now I've added all my next set of ingredients. You've seen the steps as I demonstrated prior to coming live here. Now, one of the things I want you to notice is how all the ingredients are. Looks like, how in the world are they gonna mush together? And this is gonna happen very easily because the Thermomix has a really powerful engine and blades, and it, you know, it's just gonna whip this stuff and blend it all together very quickly. So stay tuned, I'll show you in a second. Notice how it blended all the ingredients together, the eggs, the breadcrumbs, as well as the other herbs and spices, and I didn't have to get my hands all messy doing that. Wow, that's pretty amazing. Smells great too, so let's move on to the next step. Alright, I got my meatballs all rolled up. I greased my Veroma dish with a little bit of oil, and you can see I got my little meatballs in there, and Veroma dish is all greased up and ready to go. And we're gonna set these aside and start making our spaghetti sauce. Fun and smelly and tasty. Yum. Straddles off to the power, yeah. Thermomix really is a cool gadget. Not only did it chop the onions up, I'm not sitting here crying or anything like that, but the next step, we're actually gonna saute these in the olive oil that we have in there. It's gonna saute it, so it's gonna heat up the pan and actually stir the onions so that they're not sticking. It's gonna make for a perfect spaghetti sauce. I'm gonna let it saute for about 3 minutes. As you can see, the onions have been sauteed. And now we're gonna add in our tomatoes, crushed tomatoes, about 30 ounces. Okay, we got those in. And we're gonna move on to the next step. When you've gotten what you want. So we got all our ingredients in the bowl to make our spaghetti sauce, but the next step is gonna be something really interesting that most people really enjoy about the Thermomix. It's called multi-level cooking. So while we are heating and stirring our spaghetti sauce, we're actually gonna be steaming our meatballs. So I'm gonna put the Veroma mix in place here. And so you can see how everything looks. I'm gonna step back just a little bit. It's like a little spaceship. People all over the world really enjoy this feature because you can, you know, it saves time and you have one gadget on your countertop that works very efficiently for those busy people. And of course you're making meals with fresh ingredients. So you may be wondering, well, what the heck is a Veroma dish? Veroma means aroma and steam. So while it's steaming, the sauce is actually creating a very aromatic smell throughout the house, and it's cooking the meatballs all at the same time. This is amazing. I really like this gadget. So we got about 4 minutes, 5 minutes left in our steaming cycle. I'm gonna give you guys a quick peek. Open this up carefully, not burn myself. You can see how the meal or meatballs are being steamed, and at the same time, the spaghetti sauce is cooking. It's pretty amazing. Kind of like that concept. Let's let this finish up, and I believe we'll be ready to eat. All right, folks. My sauce and meatballs are done. Looks nice and creamy. Homemade spaghetti sauce and meatballs. Yummy. Now, I know a few of you may be wondering, like, did those meatballs really cook? We got one out here. We're going to cut it open for you. Show you how well the Veroma mix cooks it up. These things are juicy and tasty because we put fresh ingredients in. Now we gotta eat it up, but I'm gonna start singing because I gotta sing, who made the sauce? I made the sauce. Who made the sauce? I made the sauce. Thank you guys for watching this episode of Cooking with Gadgets. It's dinner time in my house. We're gonna eat it up. Thank you. So I did come back on and wanted to show you we did grate up some fresh Parmesan cheese. We had a block of Parmesan. And that's what that looks like. So who doesn't love Parmesan cheese with their spaghetti and meat sauce? The Thermomix is a very powerful gadget, and you can see that cheese is really fine and it's fresh. Lovely.